is their Cape Lunacy Heart. And for many years, in the 1980s, this mental health bill has been in the National Assembly. What we hear is that it's an orphan bill. For us to even know that it's an orphan bill is because of advocacy. It's because many of us have been shouting, the nurses, psychologists, Association of Psychiatrists in Nigeria. Every time we have a program like this, we always talk about the need for Nigerian government to emulate Ghana. Almost all countries in Africa have passed their mental health bill into law. Ghana passed it about 2 years, 3 years ago. But today, we do not have it. What we have is mental health policy. And even that policy is not being implemented to the letter. Advocacy groups have emanated. People have been shouting. People have been talking. People have been raising awareness. Media, both electronics and print. I cannot count the number of articles, for example, you sincerely have written with regards to the need for Nigerian government to pass the mental health bill. And what do we say? When you pass the mental health bill, it allows room for protection of the rights of those with mental illness. For example, I had a patient whose job was terminated because he just told his boss that he once had mental illness. The Federal Constitution of Nigeria, the Constitution, even discriminate against those with mental illness. It says nobody shall hold any position if he's found to have mental illness. Depression is mental illness. If I had depression 10 years ago and I'm no longer having depression, does that mean there's a problem? Does that mean I can no longer hold a position? Now, people go as far as the Republic of Benin to go and get free medication. They get free medication because why? If there is a mental health law, there will be a section that will subsidize these particular medications, but we don't have a law. The law does not even protect the rights of the psychiatrists and the psychiatric nurses and people working with mental illness. Why? You have to watch your back. Patient with psychiatric illness will say nothing is wrong with him. You have to leave him. There's no law that says, okay, based on this and this, if two or three of you have found that this person is ill and is constituting danger to himself or the public, you can sign this in law and get the person in. No, we have a Cape Lunacy law. So advocacy group has gone on, but nothing is happening. That's why the fact that we have mentioned the numerous benefits that this law seeks to provide.
So you also speak about stigmatization of victims. In this regard, sir, what will be your message to Nigerians and of course stakeholders in this regard to at least be protective to the vulnerable?
Yeah, it's simple. It's just for the it's out of ignorance. When the purpose of a thing is not abuse, it's inevitable. The abuse of those with mental illness is because of the crass ignorance in the society. People can tell you that, oh, I have hypertension. Hypertension is a disease of the heart. The heart is an organ. Oh, I have diabetes, problem of pancreas. Oh, I have liver problem. I have kidney problem. These are all problems. These are organs in our body. The brain is an organ in the body. When an organ in the body is affected, the function of that organ will be affected. My heart is to pump blood, but if it is affected, then the way it's pumping blood is high or low. So we talk of hyper or hypotension. If something is supposed to secrete, pancreas is supposed to secrete insulin and it's not doing well, I say, oh, I'm having diabetes. If I cannot see very well, then I will use glasses and say I have a vision problem. If my brain is dysfunctional, I'm going to be having problem about thinking, executive function, standing, walking, doing things. But when that part of the body is affected and I'm misbehaving, people do not relate it as, oh, it is the problem of an organ in the body, which is the brain. So they say, it is an arrow from the enemy. It is the mother-in-law. It is the sister-in-law. He's suffering from his sin. No, we must know that we should remove all the myths surrounding mental illness. Mental illness is as a result of problem of the brain. The brain is an organ equal to heart, equal to liver, equal to kidney, and the rest. I think when we have this basic understanding and remove that myth, it will help us to now understand that when I'm having empathic care for people with typhoid or malaria or diabetes or hypertension, and somebody with mental illness is also beside me, I will show the same level of empathy to say, oh, if I can cater for somebody with diabetes and hypertension, I can also cater for it because this one's problem of pancreas, problem of liver, problem of heart, this one's problem of brain, and they are all organs. So once you show that, there won't be need for stigmatization because we only stigmatize someone that has diabetes or hypertension or chronic cough or asthma or arthritis. But why then about someone that has brain problem?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.